Hi guys, welcome to Pakkana's Stadium. Today we are going to see about artificial heart. And before that, I would like to assure that it's not a clickbait or something else. Just catch me till the end of this video. That's enough for you. And yeah, let's start the video. However, for the beginners, artificial heart is just a thing, which means the machine just pump the blood all over the body when the heart is failed, which means the human heart is failed, and its mechanism and its works all just likely resemble to the human heart. When it fails to pump, it will replace and it will turn the, it will did the human heart works. Likewise, the artificial heart works. Then Paul Winchell, US television ventriloquist, was the inventor of the artificial heart. Yeah, it's just like a crazy, but you have to understand that. And in a cast party, when Mr. Winchell and Dr. Henry Hemlich, he's a doctor on the same way, he was also an inventor of the Hemlich maneuver for choking. Soon both of them are gonna become a crazy and become a great friends. And when Hemlich was after observing the Hemlich in his operation theater, Mr. Paul Winchell came up with a new idea of an artificial heart could keep blood pumping during in difficult open heart procedures or such a risky procedures. It will help, sir. But he invented this artificial heart with the advice of the Dr. Henrich. He designed this artificial heart in 1963. However, he got a patent in 1963, but he already filled the file for 1956 for the patent for the artificial heart, and he got this patent in 1963. After a long break, Mr. Paul Henschel donated the rights and designed it to the University of Art, and allowing Mr. Robert Jervik and others to build the artificial heart, and they renamed as a Jervik 7. However, the Jervik 7 was introduced as an ovoid shape to fit inside the human chest and used as a more suitable polyurethane material, which means the polyurethane material. The first Jervik 7 is built in a polyurethane material. The Jervik 7 had two pumps like the ventricles with a disc shaped mechanism that pushed the blood from the in valve to the out valve. And on December 2, 1982, Dr. William Davries implanted the first artificial heart into a retired dentist, Dr. Barney Clark, who survived for 112 days with the device placed in him. Anyway, the artificial heart was also known as a left ventricle assisted device, as they are commonly called, and now it is used as a bridge to keep the patient with a heart failure until the donors became available. Yeah, it's really a life-saving device, right? After all these artificial heart devices, the modern artificial heart devices are much smaller. They do not need to store the blood because the content flow of the impel pumps are used to keep the blood permanently circulating around the body. Yeah, it's a very good thing for the modern devices, right? Anyway, some brilliant viewers may ask, then how did the Jervik 7 will be get powered and how it works? Means it was powered by a compressed air and electricity supplied by a 6-foot, which means 1.8 meters of lifeline. It's going to be a crazy thing that you ever seen, ever heard before, but that's the truth. And the main reason for why Mr. Paul Winchell invented this artificial heart means this device means is keep the blood circulating during the open heart surgery. For the only reason for this artificial heart design is for the open heart surgery. It will help the doctors, or you know, helps the patient to survive for the operating times, for the random times. It will save the patient for our lives. That's the main reason that the artificial heart patient designed it. And yeah, that's the thing I would like to share with you. And yeah, if you like this video, please leave a comment and subscribe to my channel. And if you know extra points about this topic, please leave it in that comment box so that everyone will come to know about this thing. Yeah, see you in the next video, guys. Bye.